The function f of x is defined in the table below. Using the table, identify the domain and the range of the function. We're asked to write the answers as an ordered list enclosed in curly brackets. For review, the domain is a set of all possible inputs, or in this case, the x values, and the range is a set of all possible outputs, or y values, which should be the function values. And therefore, this column represents the possible inputs, or the domain, and this column represents the possible outputs, or function values, which should be the range. So we're asked to include the domain and range in a set of curly brackets, which look like this. We do want to list the domain, or the x values, in order from least to greatest. Notice how they already are in order from least to greatest, but if they weren't, we would want to order them from least to greatest. So we have negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. This would be the domain of f of x, and the range is a set of all possible outputs, which are given here. Notice how we do want to list 2 first because it's the smallest value. Then notice how 3 would be the next value. It does occur twice, but we do not list the repetition. We only list it once. From there, we would have 6 and then 11. This is the domain, and this is the range of the given function f of x. I hope you found this helpful.